Welcome to the fourth segment of the first lesson. We are helpless. 15 minutes. We cannot do the more the recording because it's very difficult for you to read. Yeah. In the fourth segment, first, second, third, we have discussed the different parts of the textbook, local time, standard time, universal time. Then we also have discussed about how the Indian standard time is being set. Then we also have discussed about, which is very important concept according to me, which is not discussed even in the book, that is daylight saving. As we are in the age of globalization, that I feel all of us, we should be aware about the new concept. It is not a new concept. It is being started. The daylight saving, and these are the countries. For example, daylight saving in the Northern Hemisphere, it is very interesting map. I just want you to get more and more familiar with the map, and therefore especially I got the maps which is showing the latitude and longitudes on the map. These are the latitudes, Tropic of Cancer, Tropic of Capricorn, which is the countries where you cannot say does not have a daylight saving. Can you see daylight saving is not there in the tropical countries? More in the temperate countries, which are below Tropic of Cancer and the Capricorn, they always have a daylight saving, because in these countries, the tropical countries, we don't have much of change in the daylight saving. Much of change in the summertime and the winter time. That is what very important concept which I have discussed. Now, after studying the daylight saving, it is very different parts how we keep the time, and the last part of your lesson, which is do you know, there is a question, there are the two pink color boxes in your book which is given, that do you know Jantar Mantar is an astronomical observation. It is very interesting. Whenever you will go, I want you to visit these two wonders of the world, Maharaja Savai Jai Singh II. The king of Jaipur in Rajasthan was a great astronomer and a mathematician and the architect. He built the astronomical observation called Jantar Mantar at Ujjain, Varanasi, Jaipur, Delhi and Mathura, and it is still in the working condition. I have been to this place. I have seen how it is being measured. It's very interesting to run. It's very picturesque place. You can see this is also the sun dial. This is called the sun dial. How it is being, the time is being calculated over here. It is being with the help of the instrument at the Jantar Mantar. It is still possible to see astronomical observation after the advent of the modern instrument. Now these instruments are more of an cultural heritage. I just want you to bring it to our notice that even in the past, our ancestors were knowing about the value of the time. And that's why they have studied the great event. They have understood the great event and the construction of the Jantar Mantar. Or there are many places or the many smaller, for example, our olden Panchang, which keeps hours, minutes, ghate, pare, and the fraction of the seconds also they were calculated. Their mathematics was so good. And unknowingly, we have not followed them, and we are we have not understood the main concept because it went into the large amount of rituals, which none of us will like to follow. So it is very important for us to understand this concept. If you know, the large number of people who were in the deserts, they have started the night watching, because that is the only time the night they used to cross in the desert. So they were the first who made the astronomical maps as to movement of the planets, because it's very difficult to find out the direction. And they were the great people who has studied about how the stars move, and depending upon the stars' position, they could say which month it is, which part of the year, when we never had the Gregorian calendar. The another important institute which I would like to contribute over here, National Institute of Standards and Technology, NIST, which also helps us in keeping the time, is an institute in the United States of America, has developed the most accurate clocks in the world. The clocks have been adjusted by 1 second added for or subtracted once in 200 million years. It is so accurate. On the similar way, we also have an NPL, that is the National Physical Laboratory. NIST is in USA and National Physical Laboratory is in India. We should be proud about it. And it also helps for the timekeeping. The timekeeping is very, very important concept for us to understand. I hope I have covered whatever the topics which are discussed in the book. I request all of you to read the lesson and solve the question answers behind the textbooks. They are very easy to understand, and definitely if you can refer to my explanation which I have explained to you with whatever the knowledge and whatever the PowerPoint presentation I could make it. So it is all the important concepts which we have understood about it in the first lesson. And I'm glad here that I have finished the first lesson. I hope you must have understood it. And please read the question answers and lesson and write down the question answers. If you have got the new book answer, the classwork, you write the answers in the classwork. It is the very, very important concept. Thank you. I will stop here today. And then thank you for allowing me to teach. And I hope I have cleared many of my aim. All of you know that I just want my children to be aware about what they are doing, why they are studying a particular subject, and how you can use this knowledge in your day-to-day living to make your living happy, sustainable living on the earth. Thank you once again. Bye. Good day. Stay safe. Stay home. Listen to your parents and take care of yourself. When the school will reopen, I hope a lot of contribution from you to, and I'm sure you must have understood the topic which I have covered. Thank you, children. Good day.